Buffalo is one of the most popular frameworks to build web apps with Go, but did you know there's a plugin to deploy to Azure easily and even generate code that'll integrate well with Azure services? Well, Martin Strobel is going to show us how to build a Go application with Buffalo and deploy it to Azure App Service today on Azure Friday. Welcome to Azure Friday. I'm Erik St. Martin, and with me today is Martin Strobel to talk about Go Buffalo and how we can deploy straight to Azure.
Hi, yeah, that's right. As you were saying, the Buffalo framework is one of the most popular ways of getting a web app and started and going quickly in Go. So I've been using it for a little while, making sure that all of my services can get off the ground and I can, you know, deliver them as quickly as I can. But while it was really easy to get a container using a Buffalo app because it gives you a Docker file and that kind of thing, I noticed that there was still all of this work that I had to go do to configure the infrastructure in Azure to make it so that I could run that containerized application well. And it just seemed wrong to me, right? I felt like this is all boilerplate stuff. There really ought to be a way to just go do it, get it done fast, try to get as few commands between somebody and their application running in the cloud. So we gave it a shot. If anybody's used Buffalo before, they might be familiar with the sort of default application. I can run it here on my local machine. It just starts up a background task. I can come over to a browser, pop it open, look. Here we go. Sort of basic Buffalo application. I've already set up my databases so that there's an instance running on Postgres here on my local machine in Docker.
Okay.
Now I need to sort of get it into a position where I can run it in the cloud.
We got to do it live.
Got to do it live. That's right. I want to have it in the cloud. My mom keeps telling me that things are in the cloud. I want to get it up there. There's this handy dandy plugin that's available to you now under the Buffalo Azure subcommand called provision. And if we give it the dash X flag, it doesn't actually do the deployment yet. It just goes and modifies our project so that it has the sort of portion needed so that my plugin knows how to do the deployment later in it. We give it a name.
This is similar to like an init or something like in most commands.
Yeah, that's right. So instead of doing a Buffalo init or a dep init or something like that, this one is specifically I intend on putting this particular application into Azure. Go initialize that.
Gotcha.
And we give it a name. So in this case, I'll call it Azure Friday 1. And we're off to the races. It did that pretty quick. All it did was go and hit the wire to pull down an ARM template so that it knows what infrastructure to go actually deploy in Azure. And then added the parameters that I had provided here and the ones that it had detected by going and looking at the Buffalo project into a file. So if we pop open azuredeploy.parameters.json and take a look, you can start seeing some of the particular details that we plugged in about our project. Azure Friday 1.
So recognize that, you know, we're using Postgres as the database and the database name got pulled out.
Yep.
Things like that.
Yep, that's right. And it was, as you were saying, it's just going and reading the database.yaml file that was already part of our Buffalo project. I did have to go make one tweak to it and replace the default context that Buffalo shoved in there with something that said, go look for my particular environment variable. That's where I'm going to want it.
Okay.
From there, I guess it's a good point to say, well, what if we wanted to inject some cloud services that we wanted to use? So in addition to just deploying to Azure, we can actually take this plugin and extend it out so that we can take advantage of Event Grid. Event Grid is a messaging solution that's HTTP based inside of Azure so that you can get pub/sub semantics between your services.
Okay.
So if you do a Buffalo generate.
So in this case, what you're wanting to do is provision this in addition to the things that it can auto-detect.
That's right. So you would probably want to add into your ARM template an Event Grid topic But there's also some code that you want to inject into your application to actually handle the events when event grid calls you, because we're going to be adding a subscriber portion into our Buffalo application.
Okay.
So if we say Buffalo generate event grid, we're going to call it ingress, because that's what we're going to be being, we're going to be being made aware of Microsoft.storage.blob created events by event grid. So with this one command, Buffalo goes and modifies our application to have added a new path inside of the application so that we have a new endpoint exposed that'll be able to be called by event grid and handle events that are passed to it. And we also have a file called ingress.go generated for us that will go actually let the application know that when it sees a Microsoft.storage.blob created event, it should go and it should use this hard typed, the statically typed call to go deserialize that for you. So really, if you just replace...
And now this was generated by the plugin itself.
Yeah, that's right.
This wasn't, okay.
So with one command, all of a sudden you've got stubs that you can go implement that say, hey, when a new blob is created in Azure, let me know about it, and then go call this method. I mean, it does all of the routing for you, just makes everything work.
Oh, that's awesome.
So, yeah. Let's see, so we were looking at generating that. If we want to see it running locally, we can do another Buffalo dev. And see those endpoints added into our application.
Okay.
Just lit up. So now it is time to get into the cloud. So if we take that Buffalo Azure provision command from earlier and before where we gave it a dash X to say, don't actually go do it yet. Now we're going to really do it. But we don't need to give it a name or anything because it caches those parameters and we'll use all of the same settings that we used before so that we have a deployment model that's configurable and reproducible and all the sorts of good quality stuff that you want to service. So this will take off. It's going to go make a new ARM template in Azure. This takes a few minutes. We don't want to wait for that.
Yeah.
So
we're in a hurry.
That's right. So I have the same application over here called Azure Friday 2. It's very similar. It didn't have the event grid stuff added into it. But other than that, if we take a look, it has all the same stuff. We added an Azure deploy.json and a new database configuration. And here we ran that Buffalo Azure provision and we waited for it to finish. And if we come over to our browser where I already have it typed in and we do a refresh, you'll see we have a website called Azure Friday 2 running our containerized version.
In the cloud.
Running in the cloud. talking to a Postgres database.
And all of this you were able to do straight from the Buffalo command line without actually having to go into the AZ CLI or into the portal or anything like that.
That's right. Didn't have to touch it.
Now that's superb.
Yeah, I'm really excited about it. I know it's made it so that when I time myself, I can get a website without a database from no new directory to running in the cloud in about 4 minutes. So it really, I mean, it's lickety split.
Three would be better, though.
Three would be better. I mean, I'll work on it. Bring me back next year. I'll have an update.
Well, thanks so much for coming on.
Yeah, thank you, Eric.
Today we were learning all about the Azure plugin for Go Buffalo here on Azure Friday.